Good morning, students, and how are you? How are you doing? Hope you are enjoying your weekend. That's excellent. Welcome to grade 10 physics class. This is a topic we're about to proceed to learn on this coming week. And the topic ahead of you is known as magnet and magnetic field. Firstly, let's start from magnet. Don't forget, this is just an introductory video that prepare your mind to the lesson. I will just give a brief summary, like a main idea of everything you need to know about the topic. What are magnets? I know this with your grade 10. This is not a strange topic to you. If I may ask, this is an example of a magnet. What is the common characteristic of a magnet? A magnet are substances that can either attract or what? Repel. It depends on the nature of the pole that is what? That is connected together. This is South Pole and this is North Pole. And that also leads to varieties of magnets we have. This is commonly known as a bar magnet, and this is a what? A U-shaped magnet. U-shaped with the name, the shape, U. This is a bar magnet. We S represents South Pole, and this us N represents what? North Pole. This is a brief summary about magnet. The pole of the magnet that points to the north is called the magnetic north pole, and the opposite end of the magnet is the south. It is called the south pole. That means where you see N, N means the north pole, and S is the what? The south pole. Now, before we continue the class, I want to relate this topic to what we know as magnet and electricity. What is the common similarities between them? In the general principle of a magnet, when north pole and north pole is joined together, it's what? We call it like terms. Like terms. What's the meaning of like? Like means the same, uniform, the same thing. When north and north is combined together, it's repel. Repel means what? Move away. Repel means move away from each other. The same thing, when south and south, because they are of the same identity, they are what? Repel. But when north and south come in contact, north pole and south pole, then it what? It attracts. Relating it back to electricity, when you have two cables connected to current flowing through the cable, one positive and negative is connected together. Take a look of a very simple cycle diagram. This is a board. This is a board. This is a battery. We have the plus and the minus. And we have a cable. This is very simple. We need to connect the positive side to one side of the board and the negative side to one side of the board. Then this board can give what? It can give current. Current pass through the wire and it can give what? Light. Because positive and negative are what? Connected together. Then what happens? For example, I know a standard battery, a real working battery, always have both positive and negative. But what about you have two different current carrying wire from different source? When you mistakenly connect positive and positive together, what happens? You know what happens? There will be a fire what? Explosion. Because it will repel each other. The same thing related to what? Electricity and magnet. And what is the common? Also in electricity, we have the positive side and we have what? The negative. The same thing in magnet, we have the north pole and we have the south pole. Let's move on. Let's move on. There is something I want you to know. Unlike poles, two magnets attract each other, and like poles to one another, as I've said so far. This is the south pole and this is the north pole. Now let's quickly move on to what we know as magnetic domain. What is the meaning of domain? What is the meaning of domain? Domain means a place, a region, an environment, a surrounding. For example, take a look at this. A region composed of group of atoms where magnetic fields are aligned Our life might be in the same direction or a different direction, but coming together the same way when we have the movement of particles in gas. In gas, the particles move around them. So magnetic domains are a group of region of composed of group of atoms which magnetic field are aligned in the what? In the same direction. It's moving in the same direction. That is the meaning of a magnetic domain. Take a look at this. Now, how do you conclude that this is moving in the same direction? Domain ranges in size from about 10 raised to power negative 4 to 10 raised to power depending on the magnitude of the domain. They are moving. This is representing a direction. This is what we call domain. For example, if this is my mobile phone and I'm connected to the school Wi-Fi or I'm connected to my home Wi-Fi, what happens the moment I'm out of the school area or I'm out of my house? What happens? You will notice from full bar network, if the network is full bar, it will reduce to 3 bar, it will reduce to 2 bar, 1 bar. Later, it will tell you, know what? Network. Why? Because you are not in the range of the network coverage environment or region or an area. That is why we conclude magnetic domain is composed of a group of atoms whose magnetic field are aligned in the same what? In the same direction. Then we call it what? Domain. They already align in the same direction. Let's quickly move to this. This is another example of domain. What can you say about this? The same what? Direction. Not to take much of your time. Don't forget, this is just an introductory video to the lesson we want to learn. Some material can be made, but yeah, we have type of magnet. We have a permanent magnet. We have a temporary magnet. The summary is just that. What is a magnet? Magnet is a device or a substance or an object that has the capability to attract or to repel. But they are almost made of what? Iron, copper, or metals. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon.